Hey guys! In today's video, I'm going to be talking about hyaluronic acid. Can you be allergic to it? This is something I get a lot of comments about. Hey, I've been using hyaluronic acid and I got a lot of irritation. Is it possible that I'm allergic to it? So I'm going to be covering that. I'm going to be talking about reasons why you might have problems with hyaluronic acid serums and hyaluronic acid-based products. If you are new here, welcome. My name is Andrea. I am a board-certified dermatologist. I would love it if you would subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the thumbs up. It really helps my videos out a lot. First of all, what is hyaluronic acid? Hyaluronic acid is something that is found throughout your body and plays a major role in the health of your skin. It's a natural part of your skin and it holds onto water. It helps keep the deeper layers of the skin hydrated and functioning properly. Hyaluronic acid can be found in many skincare products, and because it's a humectant, it holds onto water, it helps draw moisture into the top layers of the skin, helping to improve the moisture content, helping to improve the function and fluidity of the moisture barrier, and it also helps with smoothing out wrinkles and fine lines. Just as a result of bringing that water up to the top layers of the skin, plumping everything up, that has a wrinkle smoothing effect. There are a lot of products that contain hyaluronic acid. It may be called hyaluronic acid, sodium hyaluronate, hydrolyzed hyaluronic acid. But can you be allergic to hyaluronic acid in your products? The short answer is no. It's very, very unlikely to develop a true allergy to hyaluronic acid. Now, that doesn't mean, however, that it cannot be irritating and cause skin problems for you. And there are a few reasons why you may have developed skin problems from using hyaluronic acid-based serum. The first thing to consider is the type of hyaluronic acid in your products. Sodium hyaluronate is a high molecular weight hyaluronic acid. It stays up high in the top layer of the skin, again, holding on to water and just kind of smoothing everything out. The hydrolyzed forms of hyaluronic acid, however, are much smaller. For example, if you see hydrolyzed hyaluronic acid in your skincare products, one potential thing that may be occurring is that because those penetrate a little bit more deeply in the skin, they have a greater potential to cause irritation. Now, in your body, whenever there's tissue injury, high molecular weight hyaluronic acid is broken down to low molecular weight fragments, which actually activate your innate immune system. In doing so, these low molecular weight forms of hyaluronic acid that have been broken down, they act as danger signals, alerting your body's immune system, basically that there's tissue injury and kind of heralding, hey, come in and repair this. Because of this, in theory, applying low molecular weight hyaluronic acid to your skin, you could make the argument that potentially it might trigger inflammatory responses. However, it seems very unlikely because it's unlikely that that hyaluronic acid is actually going to get down to those deeper layers to trigger that type of response, but it's something you could consider. This product, for example, has hydrolyzed hyaluronic acid in it.
If you are using a hyaluronic acid serum, you may be actually using it incorrectly. One thing you need to understand is that because hyaluronic acid is a humectant, it binds on and brings water up to the top layer of the skin. But it doesn't hold it there indefinitely. You need ingredients in your moisturizers that are occlusives, meaning they seal in and create a physical barrier to water loss. Occlusives include things like silicones, like dimethicone, petrolatum, shea butter. And this is really important because if you don't have an occlusive, what's gonna end up happening is that that water that's been pulled up to the top layer of the skin from the topical hyaluronic acid, what's gonna end up happening is that water that's holding there is just gonna evaporate out of the skin. And as it evaporates, it's gonna pull more water out of your skin. That is going to cause more dryness, more irritation, and that can lead to skin rashes and skin problems, including flares of acne. It's not an allergy, however, it's an irritant reaction. And this is especially more likely if you live in a drier climate. That's not to say, however, that if you live in a drier climate, that hyaluronic acid is off the table. Just make sure you're using it correctly, either layering it underneath a occlusive moisturizer or using a moisturizer that has occlusive ingredients in it to seal in that hydration that the hyaluronic acid is bringing up to the top layers of the skin. Now, this is something that definitely can happen with hyaluronic acid, but remember, hyaluronic acid is not the only humectant out there. There are many others, and the same situation can arise. Marine extracts like algae extracts, chondrus crispus, glycerin. All of these are humectants that do more or less the same thing. Hyaluronic acid is just really good at it. So I'm drawing your attention to this because it's possible that other humectants may be causing the same type of issue for you. And these tips will apply to those other products as well. You may be developing irritation. It's simply the fact that whenever you increase the moisture content of the top layer of the skin, you increase the overall hydration, increase the water content, quite literally from hyaluronic acid, you can have increased penetration of other things that you may be applying to the skin, whether it be retinols or benzoyl peroxide or just other skincare products. You're gonna get more penetration. And if there is an ingredient that you are putting on the skin that is irritating, it's more likely to cause irritation when coupled with a hyaluronic acid-based product because you are getting that increased hydration in the top layer of the skin. Now, that's not to say that no skincare product should ever be paired with hyaluronic acid, but if you are developing a lot of irritation from hyaluronic acid-based products, this may be one potential reason why. It's not gonna be an issue for everyone, and it's gonna come down to your skin, the nature of your skin, and whatever other products you may be using. Not only the active ingredients in other products that you're using, but the inactive ingredients. Things like fragrance, more likely to get into the skin, cause vasodilation, redness, and irritation when, possibly when coupled with hyaluronic acid. Or truthfully, any other humectant, because remember, they're all doing more or less the same thing, helping to pull water into the top layer of the skin and increasing the water content there. Increasing penetration of other active ingredients or inactive ingredients. For example, this product by Vichy, it has butylene glycol. Now that's an ingredient that's fine. Nothing you have to fear or anything like that. But some people their skin may be a little bit more sensitive to it. And when you couple it with that hyaluronic acid, increasing the penetration of it, it's more likely to cause irritation and problems for you. The next reason that you might develop a problem to hyaluronic acid-based products is that you actually might develop an allergy to something else in a product with hyaluronic acid or products that you're using alongside it. If you're increasing the penetration of other ingredients into the skin, that is a situation where you are more likely to mount an immune response to a given ingredient. Things like fragrance may likely be more irritating to your skin, not only because of the increased penetration, but now your immune system is seeing it more, and therefore there is more likely that you might develop an allergy to that product. Last but not least, one potential explanation for increased irritation with hyaluronic acid-based products is if you are using them along with some form of topical vitamin A, whether it be prescription tretinoin, over-the-counter adapalene, a cosmetic retinol, or a cosmetic retinaldehyde. It is possible that you have more irritation when using those along with hyaluronic acid. Again, it's not to say that you cannot use hyaluronic acid with these products, not at all, but some people may have more irritation. That's actually been shown in a few studies that things that increase the moisture content in some people may make it that they're more likely to have a lot of irritation when starting a form of topical vitamin A. There's nothing to really predict whether or not that's going to occur. For the most part, we know that using moisturizers along with topical vitamin A overall reduces the dryness and irritation, but perhaps for some people, their moisture barrier is just such that increasing the overall water content, maybe by increasing the penetration of whatever form of topical vitamin A they're using, and as a topical vitamin A is going to work to increase skin cell turnover, you're losing more water. I mean, you just kind of have a clash, if you will, of things going on. So while it's not contraindicated to use hyaluronic acid-based products, and if anything, for the most part, moisturizers, including those with hyaluronic acid, are really beneficial for people who are using a topical vitamin A because they do help reduce the irritation overall. But there are some studies to suggest that anything that increases the water content of the skin can increase the irritation of retinols, especially in the beginning. It doesn't always happen, but that might be one potential explanation for the irritation that you are experiencing. So those are some potential reasons. Again, not rules, not, you cannot use this with that. You cannot, none of this draconian skincare stuff. These are just potential mechanisms that might explain why you, an individual, has a problem with the ingredient hyaluronic acid, whereas other people are doing just fine and love it. It is a beneficial ingredient in skincare because it helps to improve the moisture barrier overall. Ultimately, that actually will help in the long run in decreasing irritating things getting in and helping with improving the overall fluidity, form, and function of the skin. But in certain individuals, it may be such that the increased moisture content of the skin barrier is such that it's just too irritating. So if you have developed irritation from hyaluronic acid, what can you do? Well, it's a good idea to obviously take a break from a hyaluronic acid-based product, especially a serum. They're not necessary whatsoever. And moisturizers are an important piece of a skincare routine, but you may want to cut back on the frequency of using a moisturizer while you're going through this irritation period. It may be a good idea to even take a break from a moisturizer for a few days, or to just use sunscreen, which you should be using anyway. Most sunscreens actually are in moisturizing vehicles that oftentimes don't have humectants. As a result, they're not like the best moisturizers because they don't really impart moisture to the skin, but they do reduce water loss out of the skin. So that might be a helpful thing to use just sunscreen as a moisturizer. There are moisturizers out there that are free of hyaluronic acid. So I will list some down below in the description box. I hope this video was helpful to you guys and kind of explaining some potential reasons why you may have irritation with hyaluronic acid, but no, it's not likely an allergy. That is pretty much unheard of with hyaluronic acid. I mean, we inject it into the skin as part of filler. It's not something that people develop allergy to. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and as always, don't forget, sunscreen and subscribe. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.